Dear students, in earlier video we have discussed when a photograph by Shirley Johnson, and I hope you have understood it because each and every line by line we have discussed. Today we will discuss question answer from same poem. Page number, all of you refer page number 12, Think It Out Activity. Based on the poem, questions are easy and you can easily write that answers. What does the word cardboard denote in the poem? Why has this word been used? So here, what does the word cardboard denote in the poem? So cardboard here, it is denoting that it is the frame, and now also you can observe in some places such type of cardboard, and they have pasted in that cardboard the photograph, whatever it is there, and then actually the reason behind that, it is for long time, means we can preserve that photograph, so it is properly pasted in the cardboard frame. So this cardboard here denotes the frame which we are using for the photograph, and that is that we can preserve for long time. So here, why has this word been used? This word has been used to show the impact and the time, especially for preservance, means so many days that impact would be good. Otherwise, if you will keep the photograph, whatever it is there, separate, then so many problems may happen. But if we have that proper frame, and in past time, especially that type of task, most of the people they used to do. And here poet is referring that cardboard as a cardboard frame of a photograph. And that photograph that we have already discussed, what is that photograph, about what here poet is talking about. So that photograph, it is the sea holidays, and in that photograph, who was there in the middle? The big girl, means poet's mother, and two girl cousins in that, one is Betty and one is Dolly. And that photograph frame, cardboard frame, it is here mentioned as a cardboard. Then question number second, what has the camera captured? So we will refer first the stanza number first, in that it is given. All three stood still in a smile through their hair at the uncle with the camera. So here, how many things we are here understanding, that all three means one is big girl, that is poet is mother, and other two in next stanza that names are also given, that is Betty and Dolly. All three stood still to smile through their hair at the uncle. So they were stand still and they are looking at the uncle, and uncle here is what he is doing, he is capturing the photo with his camera. So what has captured that photo? The camera has captured the scene or that photo of the three girls in that, mother and two cousins, and along with that, was the sea holiday, said that beach scene means the sea, which is here explained as that sea is permanent and it is not changed as the other things. Means here the three names here mentioned in that Betty, Dolly and the mother. There is day by day it is changing, but the which means and the sea which appears to have changed less. So in that camera what is captured? The sea, that scene, then three girls. Because the first stanza, it is depicting the childhood age of the poet's mother. Then, what has not changed over the years, does this suggest something to you? So what has changed, what has not changed over the years and what has changed? Two things are there. First we will think about the question. What has not changed over the years, does this suggest something to you? Again we will refer to the poem, stanza number 1, in that it is given, and the sea which appears to have changed less. What has not changed? The sea has not changed because sea beauty, it is eternal, and for so many years or decades by decades, this type of understanding or the beauty, whatever things we have nowadays, we are thinking that it's temporary, but the beauty of the nature, the beauty of the sea, it is permanent, everlasting joy. That is the source of everlasting joy, and so it is mentioned as a changeless, or it is not changed. And what it is suggesting? It is suggesting that in contrast, the mother's age started changing, means the adulthood, then afterwards all the stages of the life. But the sea, it is not changed, and so here two things we can observe, that is human being, our life, it is transitory or it is temporary, but the nature, the beauty of the nature, it is permanent. Then question number 4, the poet's mother laughed at the snapshot. What did this laugh indicate? So here we can understand one more important thing, that is in the second stanza some references are given. First we will refer that references. She would laugh at the snapshot. So here for photograph the word snapshot is also used. See Betty and Dolly, she would say, and look how they dressed us for the beach. The sea holiday was her past, mine is her laughter, both brave with the labored ease of loss. So in this stanza, this answer is there. The poet's mother laughed at the snapshot. What did this laugh indicate? So this laugh is indicating that mother is observing that photograph and she is observing the childhood photograph and that memory, she is recollecting that memories. And one more thing it is here indicating, that poet is observing the happiness on the face of mother. So afterwards it is used that both brave with the labored ease of loss. So there is a loss, disappointment on both the sides, that the mother may not get that same opportunity as a sea holiday again, and the same environment and that charm on the face. So in the earlier stanza, in stanza number first, it is used the word a sweet face, my mother's. So now age group is changed, but and here poet's mother is observing her own dress and she is laughing at that. At least that moment means that laughter. Poet is thinking about that the sea holiday was her past, mine is her laughter. And for poetess, her laughter was important, her happiness was important, her satisfaction was important. So in this manner, you can write. Then next, what is the meaning of the line? Both brave with the labored ease of loss. So here, why there was a disappointment? Remains disappointment. Why there was a disappointment from both the side? So here, one thing we can understand that mother may not get that same environment, same type of situation, and that happiness. So that sea holiday was her past. And one more thing, that is, the poet may not get the same thing, that laughter from the face of the mother again and again, as now there is due to responsibilities of the family, or the age it is changed, and all that happiness, the laughter on the face of the mother means there is a disappointment on the part of the poetess also. She may not get that all that moments which are enjoyable moments, happy moments. So poet may be thinking that this type of environment, positive environment, happiness, it should continue, but it may not continue due to the age is changing. So here poet is also disappointed. Then what does this circumstance refer to? So this circumstance means now in the third stanza it is depicted that the mother is no more in the world. The poet's mother is passed away. And this circumstances means the because of the death of the mother, this circumstances means the death of the mother, that melancholic condition after the death of the mother, it is discussed. So very simple question, but the condition here on the mind of the poetess, it is the poet was not able to express her feelings, and then repetition is used that I will refer that two lines. There is nothing to say at all, it's silence, silences. And poet is unable to utter the words, unable to say anything, because silence gives some kind more meaning. Your facial expressions, your silence depicts so many things. So it's silence, silences. And especially the repetition, the poetic device, it also signifies, it also highlights that circumstances or the gravity of the problem and the melancholic stage of the, means we cannot imagine also that there would be the death of the mother. And here poetess is experiencing that after the death environment. So this circumstances refers to the death of the mother, and no one is in the state that after the death of the mother, that all that memories you would recollect, and when you are recollecting the memories, what will happen? You will not be able to manage your emotions, and after that you would feel that silence is important. You will remember all your things, and then you will think, no, again we have to rejoin our work, and you will again rejoin with the recent memories of your mother. So here, this type of things are given. Then question number 7. The three stanzas depict three different phases. What are they? So, three stanzas. In stanza number 1, here the stage it is mentioned before the birth of the poet, means the childhood age of the poet's mother. And then in the second stanza, here after the birth of the poet or the adulthood of the poet's mother, it is explained. And in the last, means death of the poet's mother and the situation after the death of the poet's mother. And here what would be the feelings, and that all that feelings after the death of the mother, it is here picturized through the poem. So emotions, poetry, what is the poetry? Poetry is the spontaneous overflow of powerful feelings, and this all that lines are spontaneous when she was remembering all the things about the mother, and suddenly that spontaneity, its spontaneous way, all that lines and that emotions, and that emotions are reflected in this poem. So thinking out all questions we have discussed, I feel that there would not be any problem in understanding the poem. All question answers we have discussed in detail. So what you have to do, task number 1, what you have to do, that is stanza 1, read carefully, write in your own words, write summary of that stanza or paraphrase of that stanza in brief. Then while writing, whatever the poetic devices used in that stanza, that also you mention after that. Then second stanza, same thing, then third stanza, and then start writing the question answers. I hope you enjoyed learning poem and question answer discussion also. So let's do